So our goal is to train a multilayer perceptron in PyTorch using lightning. In this particular video, we will be training a multilayer perceptron in pure PyTorch, and then in the next video, we will compare that to our lightning training procedure. So let's get going. When working with a script file, a Python script, I always recommend putting the imports at the top, which is, yeah, of course, the common style or convention. So we will add another function here. We will call that the compute total loss function, which is essentially analogous to the compute accuracy function, which we talked about previously. So it's in this shared utilities script where we have this compute accuracy function. We discussed this in more detail in unit 4. And in this script, we are importing this. In addition, because this is something new, I'm showing you here the compute total loss function, which works similar to the accuracy function, except here that we are computing the loss and computing the loss averaged over the number of examples. So this is something we can use to compute the loss for the whole training set, validation set, or test set, for example. Then next, another new function that we haven't implemented yet is a train function. So notice that we are only using pure PyTorch here. In the next video, we will talk about lightning and compare our code to the lightning implementation. But here for our train function, this is a function that takes in a model, a PyTorch model, an optimizer, a training dataset loader, validation set loader, a specified number of epochs, a random seed, and the device. The device could be, for example, the CPU or GPU. And then with this code, we run the training loop. It's essentially just a function that calls the training loop that we discussed in unit 4. So there's nothing new here in this part. It looks complicated, but it's exactly what we talked about in unit 4. So if this looks a little bit complicated to you, I recommend you revisiting unit 4. The only new thing here is that we have the compute total loss function here, which we defined above, and this will compute the loss for the validation set every 250 mini batches. So this is just so that we can see the total loss of the validation set and can compare it approximately to the training set loss here computed for each batch. Computing the training set loss for the whole data set would be a little bit expensive, but this training set batch loss is a good approximation. So in this part so far, we defined two functions, the compute total loss function and the train function. So these are general functions that we can use. Let's now get to the part where we actually have the code that runs these functions when we execute this script. So as always, I recommend printing some basic information. We actually don't use lightning in this script, so I can remove this. But it's always useful to have this basic information because sometimes you may be running your code in a wrong environment and you wonder why you get weird results. So in this case, I always recommend printing out some basic versions. Next, let's initialize the data loaders in the model. So we have this getDatasetLoaders function, which is a function to load the MNIST dataset. We have it defined here in the shared utilities. Here it is. It's just using the code that we also used in unit 4, but instead of adding it every time to our script, for convenience, I added it to the shared utilities. So in different scripts, I can import from this file without having to redefine it every time in my main script. And then we are initializing the PyTorch multilayer perceptron, which by the way is also included in this shared utilities file. In fact, it's exactly the same multilayer perceptron that we used in unit 4. So there's nothing new here. It's something you already are familiar with. Yeah, then optionally we are putting the model onto the GPU, and then we are defining the stochastic gradient descent optimizer here. Now what's next is of course then training the model, and for that we are going to use our train function here with the model and the optimizer that we defined above, and then we have our data loaders, we specify the number of epochs, set a random seed for reproducibility, and we set the device. Then after training, of course, we want to also know the test set accuracy, so just to have a handy comparison here, we will compute the training set accuracy, validation set accuracy, and the test accuracy, so we can compare them and see if and by how much the model is overfitting. And this is really all we need to train our PyTorch model for now. So let's actually click the run button here and see the model training. So we can see the loss goes down here, which is nice, of course. So when the model finished training, we see that we have a training accuracy of 97.6%, a 96% validation accuracy, and a 96% test accuracy. And since the discrepancy between training and test accuracy is so small, I would say the model is only overfitting a tiny little bit, maybe not at all. So in this video, we saw how we can train a multilayer perceptron in pure PyTorch, which is similar to what we have done in Unit 4. So this was for setup purposes, and in the next video, we are going to add the Lightning module and train the model using the Lightning trainer.